Yeah. Good morning. Good morning. We're gathered here for the next 3 days for the 78th winter meeting of the U.S. Conference of Mayors. More than 230 mayors from around the country are here in our nation's capital to stress to the president, to President Obama and his cabinet and congressional members, how much the American people are suffering. While national economists may say that the recession is near over, mayors know this is not the case for Main Street America. In many cities and metropolitan areas all across the country, the unemployment rate is now in double digits. Just a few examples. 13.9 in Long Beach, California, 13.4 in Los Angeles, 13.4 in Las Vegas, Nevada, 14.9% in Providence, Rhode Island, and 11.9 in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Every day we hear from constituents who have lost their jobs and people who are desperately afraid of what lies ahead. We are here to let the people of our cities know that we hear their calls for help and we are responding, and our 2010 Metro Agenda for America, let me, everybody hold up your Metro Plan for America. This Metro Agenda focuses on five key areas: job creation through direct funding to cities, a more balanced transportation bill next year that recognizes the necessity to modernize the current transportation system to daily move goods and people in our metro areas, energy independence and climate protection through green sustainable jobs, and the mayor's energy efficient block grant, improve airport security, and continued funding for proven working programs like community block grants, COPS program, the community policing service grants, and the summer youth programs and such. With unemployment in this country concentrated in cities and metropolitan areas, we know that our mayor's metro agenda will put the American people back to work. We are also releasing today a major economic report that underscores our call for a metro agenda in real numbers. This report forecast the job recovery and unemployment rate in the nation's 363 metropolitan areas, where 85% of the people in the country live. Prepared for us by Global Insight, the report also indicates that over 105 metros will still have unemployment rate above 10%, and 214 metros will have unemployment rates higher than 8% by the end of 2011. Even as the recovery picks up steam, unemployment rate will not return to lower pre-recession levels in any metro area until after 2013. The data is solid proof that we need the Senate to pass a Main Streets job package now. We are in the middle of a jobs emergency that demands decisive and swift action. Cities and metro economies generate the majority of the country's gross domestic product. These numbers show that without a robust recovery in metropolitan areas, there can be no national recovery. Our cities and our metro economies are the center of our national economy. We ignore them at our own peril. So today, we are making the case for a metro agenda, as well as the need for a stronger federal-city partnership. All levels of government must work closer together to build a bold vision for what cities and metropolitan areas will look like in the coming decade. And let me stress, this is not about new resources. It is about where existing resources need to be targeted. Thank you, and now you will hear from our team, who will speak on individual items on the 2010 Metro Agenda. And our first speaker will be Mayor Richard Daley, who will speak to us on the jobs issue. Mayor Daley.
Good afternoon. Thank you. Thank you, Elizabeth, for those kind remarks. We are here to educate, I think, Washington, D.C., about the real world. U.S. Conference of Mayors represents large, medium, small cities. It's been the forefront of job creation and opportunities for business to locate and relocate in our cities. It doesn't matter what size, in order to provide a better way of life for our people. And job creation is the key, and we heard it from yesterday from Massachusetts, very strong, about the real world. The real world does not exist in Washington, D.C. It doesn't matter if they're Democrats or Republicans, administration does not exist. The real world is outside of here, and people are concerned because what they're reading every day is the growth of China, the growth of India. It's easier to offshore jobs, but there's no reason why someone should inshore a job. You can't give a tax credit for someone for 1 year or 2 years and say stay in America as compared to India and China. So what is the tax benefit for corporations to keep their jobs in America? We are competing in a global economy. All the mayors realize their revenue is going down, their sales tax or income tax or real estate taxes. We have to balance our budget. We have to have layoffs. We have to have furloughs. And so what we're trying to educate, you have to, the Congress and the administration, about job creation. The first deal was with President Obama. He understood it with the stimulus package, but it only lasted a year or 2 years. We have to be like China. Think about 10, 15, 20 years. We talk about economic development. We talk about job creation, that the infrastructure should be 10 or 15 years, public transportation, roads and bridges, environmental issues, location of businesses in our city. What is happening here, we're forgetting about job creation. And every day someone gets unemployed or laid off. They're not being laid off. They call it the elimination of jobs. America realized, and companies and even cities realize, and governments, you don't need all the people. So how do you create an environment that business wants to expand in our country, in our communities? And to me, it is looking at whether or not you give them a tax benefit. Every employee today, if someone put an employee on today and guaranteed that employee could work the rest of their life at a decent salary with benefits, they would not pay any federal taxes. Any money left over, it would be example. You put the money back in technology and marketing, not in bonuses, not in extra salaries. You have to do something completely different we've never seen before. You cannot take the old playbook and try to play the game today, because it is a completely different environment. And all these mayors understand about jobs. We have seen jobs lost in all our cities. And how do we create an environment with the business community? You can rap and beat up the business community on a daily basis in Washington, but they create jobs. Yes. Government does not create jobs.
Yes.
Those people go to work, and those companies put people to work. They pay our local, state, and federal taxes. And it's about time we stop the nonsense about condemning whether Wall Street or any place else. You can condemn all you want. We don't condemn lawyers. You know that we never condemn lawyers in Washington or lobbyists. We never condemn them. But why is it? Why is it that America cannot come together? We come together as a nation when it comes to Haiti. We will individually and collectively put more money into charity in one day in America than the entire world put together. And that includes individuals and corporations. Why is it that we don't like business anymore? Why want business to locate in the city of Chicago? Every one of these mayors would like to have businesses locate within their cities. And to me, it's about job creation. It's not about the political rhetoric and Republicans or Democrats. What we're asking for, and this conference has stood, every former president of this conference has gone to the president and to Congress and said, you have to create jobs. And we're asking Congress and the president to understand, set aside political differences. Stop the fighting continually. And you better get on with the program, because America is way ahead of you. They understand that their student who they sacrifice to go to college cannot get a job, and they have to pay student loans. Their father just got eliminated from a job. He cannot get a job, or the wife. They're lucky they got a second job. And so what we're asking for in the metro, it's not a big city, it's a metro. I congratulate Elizabeth, I congratulate all the other presidents, really identifying what job creation can mean to this country. Thank you very much.
Thank you.